Hey guys, welcome to Yoshimura, Swapmoto Live. Thanks for coming today. I'm just gonna give you a tour of Yoshimura. There's been a lot of changes here. Like, a lot of people still don't really realize that we make everything from raw materials here in the United States, here in Chino, California, which we're in a state that really doesn't, isn't excited about manufacturing. But we do it here because, as you see through this video, there's a lot of people. We have about 100 employees that work here, and everybody's family. There's people that have like a 32-year history here working for Yoshimura. So we're kind of planted in Chino, California. So here we're in our lobby. You can see a lot of the cool stuff that some of the memorabilia, some of the number one championship plates that that Yoshimura has garnered over the years. But we have Yusaku Yoshimura with us on the tour today, and we're gonna have fun. Thanks for coming along with us. So this is a 40-year history kind of we did when we celebrated 40 years with Suzuki going road racing with them, which is a milestone. You know, you think back when how many companies are in partnership, and it actually lasted 41 years. This was celebrating the 40th, but we were super excited about this this happening in 2018.
Hey, for you guys, Suzuki and Honda have always been the two big partner OEMs with you. What is it about that relationship?
What is it about the relationship? So we started the relationship with Suzuki in 1978. We started racing with them. But it's funny, if on your website, you can actually go and there's a history of Yoshimura on our website. You can click Yoshimura history. And the very beginnings of Yoshimura going racing, like the early 60s, we were racing with Honda. And we were racing with Honda parts, and we started racing against Mr. Honda and his factory team over at Suzuka. And so we have a very, very early history of racing with Honda as well. So it's just when you grow relationships, we like to stay with these people. And since 2005, the end of 2005, we started working with Honda. And in 2006, we started racing with them on the off-road side. And we just signed another 3-year agreement, which you guys might know of, that we're super excited about. So I think it's kind of like when we're involved with a relationship with a company or a race team, we like to think that we're kind of married for life kind of thing. So this is kind of our wall of fame kind of. These are the people that make our Yoshimura product, and we're super proud of them. And these people that make our product are Yoshimura. That's super important to us to celebrate these guys. Like I said, many of them are family. Brothers, sisters, cousins that work here long term.
You know, as you said earlier, so many people stay here for a while. They just find out, hey, this is a great job, this is a great thing. That's not a lot of loyalty in certain brands in this industry. You know, there's some turnover, so you guys definitely are doing something right if people are going to stay around for 20, 30 years.
I think it's just, we're not making people rich here. If you really like working here, you like working here. When COVID hit, we lost about 20% of our workforce, and they never came back. So we were operating since April 2020 on about 20% less people than we used to have. But those people that are here now, those 80% are diehard Yoshimura workers. And they, like I said, they have 5, 10, 15, 20, 30 plus years here. And it's just that they're just locked into Yoshimura. They like it here, and they know what to expect. And we treat them fairly, and we try to pay them fairily too. Yeah, that's a Steve Caballero poster that we did. We did 500 of them. For a small bar event, we were doing drag races. So this is Elias right here. I'm pretty sure he's our oldest employee. I think 32 or 33 years. So we'll meet him in the back. But Elias has been building mufflers since it was just him in the shop, and now I think he's got 12 people under him.
Oh really?
Yeah. So this is final assembly when they build the mufflers.
Okay, so then how much, like you said, goes on here? This is full start to finish.
Yeah, so we get raw materials in, whether it's composites in for carbon fiber, stainless steel, titanium, flat sheet material. It all comes in here. About the only thing we don't manufacture in here is stickers, rivets, springs. We make a lot of our own washers, mounts, all kinds of things. So you'll see in the back that one of the things that Yoshimura is famous for is their fitment. So every single exhaust system is made to fit on that motorcycle. So every bracket, every core, the baffle of the exhaust system, it's all custom tuned to that specific motorcycle. We don't take a muffler off one bike and put it on another because it might fit. It's all custom made for that motorcycle. So this is our marketing and sales office. This is Tim Welch. He's our sales manager and I do all the marketing here at Yosh. So yeah, this is kind of like what we stare at every day. Tim and I are joined at the hip here and share a lot of sales and marketing functions together. But it's good that way. We bounce stuff off each other and make each other sharper. So it's good.
The memorabilia collection is impressive.
Yeah, well, it's, you know, I like to think that like this is kind of the fun stuff about, you know, you look back at some of these number plates and it, this is the plate that the Jet won the championship on. And I was asking for a plate all year. And they're like, Cam was like, here, dude, this is yours. I'm like, are you kidding? He's like, you've been asking for it all year. I'm like, that should be yours. And he gave it to me. So yeah, that's Hangtown Dirt on there. So it's fun to have this stuff. And it's good to know that as I'm sitting here looking at some of these plates, like Eli Tomac, Tim Geiser, Trey Kennard, gosh, there's just so many Ken Rocks, and you know, even here on the Suzuki wall with Ken Rocks and Weston Pike and Vogel and Tickle, like there's so much stuff that you look back and you just, you know that we're in this thing deep, so it's cool. Yeah, so we're gonna walk out in the warehouse out here, but one of the things you'll see all around the place is these win ads that we do. We put them in Cycle News. I actually print each one of these off and send them to the riders when they win, or the mechanic, depending on who it gets it. And then I stick one up in the hallway here because it's really important for us to make sure that these guys know that they're building world-class product that win races around the world. So it's good wallpaper too. So.
Looking around at some of this stuff, efficiency seems to be the name of the game here at Yoshimura. From the order warehouses over here, safety records, shipping, all that stuff. How important is it for you guys to maintain that, especially with a product that's so expensive, a niche market, these kinds of things where you don't really have a lot of wiggle room?
Yeah, I think like we were talking about earlier, for the employees, we want to create a safe, fun working environment for them. So that's why you see Yoshimura's been doing this for a long time. We've been in business since 1954, been in business in the United States since, I want to say it was mid 70s or so. And there's so many processes as we walk through this building, there's so many checks and balances and processes, whether we're making bicycle pedals or exhausts or fender eliminator kits or whatever that might look like. There's a testing, there's an R&D, there's testing, all the way through to it's a final piece in a box that's going to the customer. There's a lot of processes involved. So there's we're not just bending tubing and stick it into a box here. So it's really important for us to have, there's procedures to follow, there's a lot of protocol. And again, that makes it straightforward for the employee. And there's, you know, when we pop a new guy into a position, this is how you do it. So there is a definite Yoshimura way of how doing things, and I think that just goes back to we're building a quality product. We have, I think from my aspect, we have one of the best customer service records in the industry, so it's fun for me to work here as well. Yeah, so these are CRF 450 exhausts that just came out of muffler assembly. They're meeting the header that comes from the pre-assembly over there. And over here is where the last guys really that touch the product that are putting it in the boxes to get shipped out. This is Chris and Andy over here. And these guys basically box every Yoshimura system that goes out around the world. Yeah, so those are our cardboard boxes. Funny story, about 5 months ago, we were having we had about a 4-day lead time to our cardboard supplier. And it turned into 2 weeks, 4 weeks, and then 8 weeks. And we were building product depending on what boxes we could get, because we make a wide variety of stuff here. And so we were looking at our cardboard and saying, okay, well, what are we gonna package today? So even things like cardboard we're waiting on because of this crazy thing we're going in that's happening in the world.
Okay, so then even on the packing efficiency, you guys have really figured that out. Rather than doing consumables, styrofoam, stuff like that, even just doing this recyclable paper that you can probably buy way cheaper that has a better life. Everything you guys are doing is efficiency, huh?
Well, we're trying to think about every step of the process, you know, from not just building a great exhaust pipe, but getting it to the consumer, being responsible with the packaging that it comes in. Like, we can talk about it, but we have a whole refurbished process. So like, if you crash your bike, if it needs to be repacked, whatever happens, you can send your exhaust system back to us and we'll repack it. If it's crashed, we can replace components. But you could use the same box that it comes in to ship it back. So this is something, a service that we provide here at Yoshimura. Like, nobody knows the exhaust better. You can ship it back to us and we can repack it for save a lot of headaches for the consumer. So, but yeah, we try to think of that when we're building a box to ship to the consumer new. They could ship that product back to us in that same box and it'll be safe. But also using recyclable materials, we want to be responsible with that. Packaging.
You know, and the other thing you said too, the solar panels on the roof, we're not gonna see that, but in every shape of the business, you guys have to think that way now. There, it's not just thinning pipes, selling them out there. There's way, way more to it than what people might assume thinking of a pipe company.
Yeah, again, we just, when people wanna get hired again, we'd love to hire a second shift. But, you know, at 3 o'clock, Southern California Edison charges us about 3 times the amount of kilowatt hour to run the machines and run this place. So we had to do something. So now the whole roof now is full of solar panels. And we're basically, you know, we were shutting lights off and fans off and all that kind of stuff at 3 o'clock to make sure we weren't paying all this extra power. But now we're selling power back to Edison. So it's pretty cool.
I'm looking at this shipping bay right now. The addresses that this is going to is unbelievable. For you as a guy that works here and sees that, when you see a Yosh pipe is going to Russia, to Israel, to New Zealand, South Korea, and then to Florida, that's pretty unbelievable that you guys have the spread that you do.
It's really humbling, really.
Really, and you have to think too, what goes on in the motocross or the motorcycle world over there that they're like, yeah, I got to get a Yoshimura pipe. Do you get a lot of feedback from those people?
Here's the feedback right here. You're seeing it, right? They buy it. So in some countries, you know, our exhaust systems are expensive here. They're really expensive there. So you think about a Yoshimura exhaust system going to New Zealand, it's way more expensive there because of duties and shipping and all that stuff. But you know, again, that's humbling for us because worldwide, like I was saying earlier, we ship exhaust worldwide for the Yoshimura brand. So it's pretty humbling to just really absorb that people are our products in demand worldwide. And I think it's just really, it's Pop Yoshimura from back in the very early days. He set a bar of excellence for this company that we try to hit every day. Like, I try to tell people we are not a perfect company by any means. But every day when we walk through the door, there's a bullseye that we want to hit, and that's making a great product and giving great customer service. So we try to hit that every day. Sometimes we miss and we try to make up for it, but on the whole, I think we do a pretty good job. So we're in the final assembly room here at Yosh. So we're in the room where they basically build the muffler from start to scratch. So we gauge our business and the effectiveness of a day by how many mufflers we build. And we're probably about between 180 and 250 a day is our capacity in this room. And there's people that specialize and do this stuff all day long. Come on over here, we'll show you. Elias! This is Elias, the supervisor here. How long have you been here?
32 years.
32 years. So he was in this room, well, not this room, but when it was just him building mufflers. Yeah. So he's one of the happy employees.
Oh, yeah.
So this is a machine this is basically one of our packing machines. We still do stuff by hand too, but this machine's really cool. This is all packing material here on this pallet. Comes through this machine and he sprays the packing material in. And like I said earlier, each muffler is specifically designed to have a specific amount of grams of packing in it. When it reaches that limit, the machine shuts off. So it's exact every time with the amount of packing. And what's cool about this packing, it's not all these different filaments in there, it's one long strand of packing material. So it's pretty cool how it works. Exhaust systems or mufflers come in from consumers that need to get components put in or just a repack. And this is basically the wall where we do that. We actually keep some fixtures here for high velocity pieces. So when somebody sends their exhaust system in, we'll check if it's been crashed, we'll check alignment. If it needs to be straightened out, we'll do that with the fixture. If it needs components, we'll put it in. If it just needs a repack, we'll do that. And it's really economical. It's maybe a depending on when you send it in, it's about a week turnaround to get a muffler repack. And it's super cheap. It's usually like 80 bucks to get it done. And believe me, if you've ever repacked a muffler, it's worth it. But what's one of the coolest things that happens is when somebody gets their muffler back, they a lot of times they're like, hey, this isn't mine. Because we polish it, it gets new badges, it looks like a brand new piece. So they're like, this isn't my muffler. So, but that's the care we take into when people send it in. This is, these are orders that we're getting ready to ship out to distribution, our big distributors here in the US, so Tucker and WPS. So usually at the beginning and the middle of the month, this is bare. And by the middle and the end of the month as we ship two times a month, this place is packed getting stuff to get shipped out. So we really don't have any, nothing's really going on the shelves right now because everything that we're making is sold. These boxes right here, this is all titanium from Japan. We get our titanium from Japan from a known supplier. The grade's the best grade we can get. And it's just a consistent grade of titanium for us. So that stuff comes in. It's pretty funny for the Works Edition product. It comes from Japan. We develop it and make the system here and we ship it back to Japan for the Works Edition systems. And then the bike comes back to the United States with that same tubing on it. So that's the tubing that goes around the world a couple times. We're in R&D here, so out here is where the fabricators work and they're building tooling. Over here, we're working on the Westby Superbike on that side. So we built all the factory Honda product. Three guys build it right here. That's for Ken Roxon, Tim Geiser, the Honda racing team from around the world. So all that stuff is built here. The fixtures that are basically designed in R&T get built out here and then go onto the production floor. Even down to the boxes, like we were talking about earlier, these guys will engineer the box specifically for that product to go out. So a lot of moving parts in here, but this is kind of really the heartbeat of Yoshimura. It's designed and developed here, and then it goes out to the floor to get made. This is our dyno room in here where we do a lot of the, obviously the checking of the horsepower and the torque of the bike. Right now we have a Yamaha R7 on here, but usually this thing's running pretty much all day long. When we get bikes in here, we'll roll them up on this stand. We'll basically look at where the catalyst is in the muffler. So it's all about, a lot of it's about emissions nowadays, making sure we're not tampering with that. Then we'll roll the bike into here. And in here, the bike will get scanned by this faro arm. We'll scan all the data points of the bike. And then we can bring that information right into our CAD data into the computers. We pretty much know a lot by doing this for a long time what the bike is probably going to need. And these guys can design some prototype pieces right away. And we'll test it on the dyno. So the production or the development time is cut considerably by just the process that we have going on right now. So, and then over here, pretty cool. These are a couple of 3D printers or additive manufacturing. So this machine actually prints in an ABS material. This machine actually prints in a carbon fiber material. So some of this stuff is actually used for tooling. Over here, we can actually use some of this product. Our race teams in the past have used product that actually this printing machine actually can go racing with. So we're up here in one of our mezzanines, and what we keep up here, we try to use try to be really efficient with our space, because this is basically another floor. Down here is where we keep a lot of the older tools, a lot of the older fixtures. So if we want to ramp up and build an older system, we keep that stuff available. So that's here. And then in this room, this is our kitting room. So this is where we build all the parts kits that'll meet the exhaust systems downstairs. So wash plugs, springs, washers, all those things are getting built in kits for that specific bike. And then it'll go downstairs and it'll meet its the muffler system that it's supposed to be paired with. So one of the processes we don't do here is finishing. So we send product out to get anodized every day. So you see right here, this is our pedals that we've been making and have been so successful with. But this machine will actually laser etch our logos on them, onto the pedal. And over here you can see, this is one of the ways we use 3D printing. This is the tool that holds the pedal. So this is a 3D printed piece, and it holds the pedal in the exact spot to get laser etched.
Why the bicycle pedal?
So, a guy named Don Maeda brought a specialized Levo by one day for Yusaku to ride, because I've been bugging him to go mountain bike riding with me. And he went mountain bike riding and like the next week he bought a stump jumper and just fell in love with mountain biking. This is like probably the end of 2017. And he came to me and said, hey dude, I think I wanna make bicycle stuff. And we have all the machinery, we have boxes, we have the engine to do this. And so he developed this pedal that's just taken the world by storm, and we can't make them fast enough. And it's really exciting because I think it's really becoming another branch of Yoshimura. There's a division of Yoshimura in Japan that actually makes darts, because somebody has a passion to make darts, and they're the sickest titanium darts you could ever throw. So this is kind of our passion, and me and Yusaku are basically to kind of do this together. And it's really exciting because I was in the bicycle industry before I came into the power sports industry. And when he wanted to do this, I was like, I've done this before, let's do it. So yeah, we're making pedals, and we just came out with our new stem for mountain biking. And it's really, really a fun project. A lot of times late at night when everything's done, the lights are off inside, Yusaku's out here building pedals. This is Yoshimura Cycling right here. This is where Yusaku builds all the pedals. So these are 3D fixtures that he made to hold the pedals as he's working on them. And then over here, these are our pins. One of the coolest things is we almost make all the components for this pedal here. We don't make these fasteners. These are made about 20 miles away. The spindles are actually heat treated about 20 miles away. They're Cerakoted about 20 miles away. There's a couple of outside processes. One of the things we don't make here is the bearings. We went through about 5 different suppliers on the bearings, and we found that the best bearing we can get was from Japan, ironically. But everything else we were blowing apart, and these bearings work really good. So these are the trays where we store stuff, extra pins, bearings, pins through here. These are where we usually keep the stock of pedals. Right now we're not making them fast enough, so they're not in there. These are some extra caps that we make here. These are an IGIS bearing bushing that we actually order out. And then these are extra spare pins that come with the pedals. And then down here, another cool thing that Yusaku has done, he's made left and right spindle holders. So these are 3D printed pieces that hold the spindles. So like I said, we developed this, this is a proprietary metal that we've built the spindle out of. After it gets turned, it goes out to get Cerakoted, then it comes back and it gets turned, or actually heat treated, then Cerakoted. Then we turn it one more time to make sure it's straight, and then it's ready to get assembled in a pedal. So what's cool about this operation, these are our tube benders. In the last probably year and a half, we've invested about $3.5-4 million in new machinery here at Yoshimura. So just to really increase efficiency, accuracy, and make a better product. So these are new electronic servo tube benders that actually the guys in R&D can talk to these machines with data, and they'll make sure that the tooling's in place, and they can bend up a tube and stick it in this light table over here just like he's doing. It'll scan the tube, and if it's made wrong, it'll calibrate the machine and then go right into production. It's interesting fact, we got that scanning booth from Tesla. It was a moving sale. You can actually see this machine's cutting mounts for a CRF 250 or 450, but starts out as a flat sheet of material just like this. Yeah, so one of the coolest things about laser cutting is it's a really efficient way to use material. You can see there's not a lot of space on here that's not been used. And then speaking of recycling, we have a recycler that comes about 3 times a week that picks up all of our aluminum, our tie, and our stainless. So we really have a lot, we don't have a lot of trash here to throw away. So this is our baffling department. So we make about 15 different styles of mufflers. And even though the muffler might look the same, internally it's very different and modified for that specific bike like we were talking about earlier. So this is the department where they're basically making the core, the inside, the baffle for the muffler. So it might need a screen, it might need stainless steel, and you can kind of see each one is very unique to its own piece. These laser machines require 400 PSI. The shop basically runs on about 140, 150 PSI around the shop, but
with this, these laser machines, they have to require 400 PSI, so we had to have a whole new system put in for to create that pressure for the machines. So this is the canister department. So all of our canisters start off as a flat sheet of material, and then the holes are punched in or laser cut in that first part of the process. Then they're brought over here to one of these rolling machines to either make it a round tube, an oval tube, a tapered tube, or a conical tube. All these machines roll it. Kind of see that starts off with a flat sheet here, and then you can see the canister here. Then we move down here, you can see here, this is probably for the front rezo for a CRF 450 or 250 motorcycle muffler. These are the welding machines that'll weld these canisters up, and again, we leave this protective tube coating on as long as we can, but you can see we'll stitch the canister like that. Oh, here you go. Look at that. So this is our tank department over here where we do all the cool, beautiful welds, and yeah, nobody makes a muffler bracket like that. Look at that thing. Look at the welds. The CRF 250 canister, titanium. This is a header for a 22 Grom dual muffler system that we had the idea to make, to just make something crazy off the wall. So it's all titanium, $1,500 system for a $3,500 bike. And we can't make these fast enough. So here, we're in our stamping department here. We have 45 ton presses, 80 ton presses. And so we make all of our end caps here, our muffler brackets. And again, everything is, if you can see on the wall here, there's so many different kinds of custom brackets we make to fit that application. But after we stamp a piece, it comes, you know, comes over here. This is the last part of the process where it stamps it from this, where it has no holes, to this, where it has all the holes at once. And it's actually stamped all at once because you get a lot more accuracy when it's done all at once rather than doing one hole at a time. So we're in our composites department here. This Johnny over here, he's the head of this department. And this is basically where we do all our carbon fiber. So our carbon fiber comes in, it's pre-preg, so it has the resin already built into it. It's kept at about 0 degrees in here. When it's time to build some material, we bring it out, we thaw it out. It comes on this table, and Johnny here actually has specific templates to cut the material to. And he builds kits. It's almost like a vinyl plotter the way it works, but it has a different blade on it. And then this is an example of how workable the carbon fiber is. This is scrap, but it's almost like paper. You can kind of just lay it up. It's sticky from the resin. We'll come over here. They'll take those kits. They'll have them in the freezer here. These are all pre-built kits here. They'll probably lay them on these hot plates, and they'll lay them up into the cavities and get them ready to go into the oven outside. So these are the inserts for the to go inside the cavity once the carbon's laid up. It's basically a silicone piece that is laid in, that it expands at a very high, when it gets heated up, it pushes out to about 10,000 PSI. In the machine shop, we try to make as much stuff on the property as we can to keep that quality control, not be so vulnerable to a vendor. So we machine all our product here, whether it's a washer, an O2 sensor bung, our bicycle pedals are made on this machine. Now our new bicycle stem is being made on this machine. So everything we make here is, we try to make as much stuff as we can, so just leave less error to the system. So yeah, even like down to the O2 sensor, make the cap and the bung for this, and just a real precision fit on these machines. And then also even down to washers, like. So guys, thanks so much for coming on this tour. We're in the spot where basically everything's boxed up and getting ready to go out to a distributor around the world. We really appreciate your time hanging out with us. Really important for, you know, you guys watching this video to understand all the the crazy complexity and the detail and the thorough thought that goes into making our product. We really feel it's a high quality product, and I think it shows when the consumer gets it, you bolt right on. All that stuff, nothing when you get a Yoshimura exhaust, nothing's by accident. Everything's planned out. So thanks for coming on the tour with us today. Have a good one.